Sleeth. Okay, so could you say who you are and what you're doing here?
My name's Matthew Sleeth. This is the Generative Freeway Project. And so I'm with four 3D printers, I'm building a freeway system. So it's the idea of a set of instructions with the printers building a system which is the freeway, so a set of instructions building, instead of... Actually, can we start again?
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
That got a bit tangled up, that one. All right, so did you just ask me? Yeah.
Just say, start, go from the start again, I think.
Okay. So, my name's Matthew Sleeth. This is the Generative Freeway Project, and it's the idea of a bunch of 3D printers in the gallery building a freeway system. So, it's the idea that a set of instructions in the printers builds the part that then builds the freeway system. And so as people come in, they can pick up the parts from the printers or a staging area and then help construct the freeway. So I'm very interested in what 3D printers can build, but I'm also mainly interested in them as kinetic sculptures. So I kind of situate this in the tradition of kinetic sculpture and performance that I'm in here all the time, you know, working with the machines and working with people that come to help build the freeway, and that the machines are sort of the actors in this, that they're going all the time and the sound and light and movement comes from them. And it's really just the idea that a set of instructions are building the part, and then the parts are then forming the system, and the freeway is a metaphor for kind of the systems that we create as a community.
So I've heard quite a bit about 3D printers, but what are they exactly? I mean, could you explain?
Well, these are really just plastic melters with a robot underneath them. They really are drawing the part by melting plastic onto a platform that moves around underneath, or in the case of two of them, the heads move and the platform stays still. So it's actually quite a simple technology that has become a kind of a very active community. And through the community, it's actually kind of the knowledge is transferred, and it's become sort of, you know, a real moment in the culture, I think, at the moment. But while I'm interested in that, and I'm partly interested in the nature of 3D printing, I'm really interested in them as partly as what they can make, partly in their relationship to photography and video, which is sort of my background, and the idea of the negative or a set of instructions forming a human-readable multiple is sort of something I think about quite a lot. So in some ways for me, this is a kind of cinema or a kind of photography. But I'm mainly interested in them as performance and the idea of a linear narrative through the piece, that there's a beginning, middle and end to the freeway.
Okay, that's brilliant. Let me come a little bit closer to you and talk a little bit more in detail about this. Can you explain some of these objects?
So this is the first one. This is a prototype 3D printer that I made myself with some friends in New York, and that was part of a hacking group at NYC Resistor, and they went on to become MakerBot. So through the three founders of MakerBot came out of that community. And so that's an early version of something that became the Cupcake, which was their first product. So there's kind of a lot of custom electronics and hacky add-ons to make it work.
This one isn't actually going to move, but is it?
It can be.
But so what is
that one needs a computer net attached to it to go. It doesn't print autonomously. So that's got quite a small build platform, so that actually builds the pylons for us.
Thank you.